Hello, and welcome to the Google Scholar tutorial. I am Emily Reed, the Instruction and Reference Librarian at the Charles T. Jones Leadership Library at Central Penn College. Let's talk a little bit about how Google prefers you to search. Google recommends that you begin your search exploration broadly, then narrow it down as you discover more specific topics you're interested in. You should also consider what web sources you should use. Should you use Wikipedia? For academic research, the answer is definitely no. Should you use a government website? A health organization? It's also a good idea to keep track of your searches. Google Docs is a good tool to keep track of what websites you visit. You can insert live hyperlinks into the doc to make the websites easily accessible from your notes. Finally, plan to learn along the way. You probably don't know everything about your topic yet, so plan to modify your searches as you learn. To begin, we will learn how to use basic search and advanced search in Google Scholar. Next, we will learn how to read and use the results page. Then, we will learn some unique Google Insider tips. To access Google Scholar, either type the address into the web address bar, www.scholar.google.com, or simply Google Google Scholar. It will be the first result. This is what the basic keyword search looks like. To get to advanced search, you have to click the little arrow at the right end of the search bar. Here's what advanced search looks like. When you type words into the first box, Google will only return results that contain every single word in that box. When you type words into the second box, Google will search for those words right next to each other. It's the same as typing a search in quotation marks. Typing words into the third search box will return results that have any of the words, but not necessarily more than one. For example, if you type the words organ donor, results will include anything with the word organ and anything with the word donor, not only results with the phrase organ donor. The fourth search box will omit any results with the words you typed in. This can be very useful. For example, let's say you're searching for information about the car company Jaguar, but results about the Jaguar cat keep resulting. You could type the word Jaguar in the first search box, then put the words animal and cat in the fourth search box. Any sites about jaguars that mention cats or animals will not show up in your results list. Next, you can choose where your search words appear, whether they can appear anywhere in the article, or if they must appear in the article's title. If you are looking for a specific article, or want to look up works authored by a specific person, you can type the name of the author into the search box. If you know which journal or other publication you wish to search, simply insert its title into the appropriate search box. If you want to indicate a particular date range, you can do that as well. Simply enter the years into the boxes with the earlier year in the left box and the later year in the right box. Let's try out using the advanced search. See if you can locate the following article in Google Scholar using advanced search. Pause this tutorial to perform the search. In a few seconds, I will show you how I searched for this article. Okay, hopefully you've found the article. Here's how I searched. I put the first part of the title into the exact phrase search box. I told Google to search for those words only in the titles of articles. I input the first author's last name into the author box. I knew which journal it was published in, so I typed medical teacher into the publisher box. Finally, I knew it was published in 2012, so I limited my results to only return results published in 2012. When I searched, this article was my only result. Keep this article loaded in your browser. We'll come back to it in a little bit. Now let's learn how to read and use the results page. The title of each article is the large blue link at the top of every result entry. The format of the item is included in brackets at the beginning of the title. Here we have three books. Other formats you might find include citation, HTML, PDF, PPT for a PowerPoint, and DOC for a Microsoft Word document. The green rows of text beneath the titles tell you publication information, including who the authors are, who the publisher is and when it was published, and the hosting website. A description of each item appears next. Notice that the search terms are bolded not only in the descriptions, but in the titles as well. The last row of information is easily missed, but contains extremely useful Google tools. You can see how many other articles and books cite the work. If you like the idea of one article, click on Related Articles to find articles about similar topics. You can also see all the versions that Google has access to. The article may have been republished in a number of other journals, or even websites. Google even provides you with a Cite button. But user beware, they often contain mistakes, and you are still the responsible party to turn in correct citations. You can also save articles to your library folder, but we'll talk more about that later. So you can see information about these results, but have you ever been frustrated to click on one of the links only to find that you can't read the article without paying a fee? Any articles that you have free access to will appear as a link in the right pane. If there is no link here, then the site may ask you to pay for access to the article. If you decide you want to see recent titles, you can limit the year of publication in the menu on the left. The default sort order is by relevance, which places the most relevant articles at the top of the results page, but you can choose to sort by date if you prefer so that the most recent articles appear at the top. Okay, let's test your skills. Do you still have the article you searched for loaded in your browser? See if you can figure out how many times the article has been cited and how many versions there are. Pause this tutorial while you check, and in a few seconds, I'll share with you what I found. Okay, did you find the answers? As of the date of this recording, November 21st, 2015, this article has been cited 31 times and there are 8 versions. Depending on when you are watching this tutorial, these numbers may increase.